Good morning. So we thank you for being with us today as we celebrate the Lord's Day through holy worship. Please note that the bishop strongly encourages those present to wear face coverings during the liturgy. The priests and deacons will wear coverings until they reach the altar during the readings and also during communion. Since we are not able to physically pass the collection baskets, you will find collection baskets or money boxes at the baptismal font and by the doors and the transepts in order for you to make your donation to the church. And you can do that either before or after Mass. Please help as you are able. Finally, you will notice we will not have worship aids since they cannot be reused, and it will make it easier for us to clean for the next Mass. But we're happy to announce that if you are worshiping with us in person, you can scan the QR codes located on the doors to the sanctuary. So you'll find a piece of paper with this black square. If you simply open your phone's camera and you put that on there, it will open up the worship aid. For those that are worshiping with us via the live stream, you can find the worship aid online. A link is available on our website homepage. So thank you for being with us this morning, and we will start Mass in just a few moments.
And of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning. So we have right now Deacon Ken is with us. He is newly ordained deacon and assigned at St. Jude's. Welcome. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault.
Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, blessed Mary of Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, pray for me
to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down, and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
have visited the land and watered it. Greatly have you enriched it. God's watercourses are filled. You have prepared the grain.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
Thus have you prepared the land, drenching its furrows, breaking up its clods, softening it with showers, blessing its yield.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
You have crowned the year with your bounty, and your paths overflow with a rich harvest. The untilled meadows overflow with it, and rejoicing clothes the hills.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
The fields are garmented with flocks, and the valleys blanketed with grain. They shout and sing with joy.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared to the glory to be revealed to us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we await for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke it to them at length in parables, saying, "A sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep, and when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The disciples approached him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven has been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. From anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away. This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see, and hear but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them, which says, 'You shall indeed hear but not understand. You shall indeed look but never see.' Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I heal them. But blessed are your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Hear then the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it, and the evil one comes and steals away what has sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy, but he has no roots, and it lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100 or 60 or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today's readings are about the transforming power of the Word of God when read, preached, and lived. They also warn us not to be disappointed at the absence of immediate results. We must take a positive and optimistic view of our missionary efforts as we keep on bearing witness to Christ's gospel. In the first reading, Isaiah consoles the Jewish slaves in Babylon, assuring them that like rain and snow, which water the earth so that seed may sprout and grow, God's word will accomplish its purpose in this case by returning the exiles to their homes in peace, as God promised. In the second reading, St. Paul reminds us that just as seeds must fall into the earth and die to produce abundant crops, the pain and sufferings God permits in our lives help our redemption. Today's gospel teaches us that the word of the Lord is the seed, and our hearts and minds are the soil. The seed's good spiritual yield in one's life depends on how fully one willingly accepts and responds to the word of the Lord. The parable tells us to do our part by preparing fertile soil in our hearts, in which the word of God can germinate, grow, and yield 30, 60, or 100-fold. This parable challenges us to listen intently to God's word, to be open to it, and to allow our lives to be shaped by its power. The parable reminds us that man's reception of God's word is determined by the condition of his heart. We need to assess our use of the word of God. We need to read the word of God every day, starting with a prayer to the Holy Spirit for the gifts of attentive reading and the ability and willingness to apply the message we receive to our daily living. When we listen to the word of God as read and preached in the church during the Holy Mass, we need to pay full attention to the message given by God, who uses the clergy as his instrument. We also need to ask God's special grace to remove all types of blocks like laziness, anxiety, worries, and the burden of unrepented sins, any of which can prevent the word of God from influencing and transforming our lives. When we receive Jesus, the word of God, and the source of the word of God in Holy Communion, we need to ask him to transform our lives. We need to keep our spiritual soil fertile and prepared for the word of God. We need to keep our hearts open to the word of God instead of closing it with pride, prejudice, fear, or laziness. We have to remove from our hearts the weeds like evil habits and addictions, evil tendencies, hatred, jealousy, fear, and greed. We should not allow the trials and tribulations of this world, the cares of this world, our ambitions, and our desires for worldly success and worldly happiness. Amen.
Now let's proclaim our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Christ is the sower of the seed of God's word. Let us respond to his work by praying to the Father.
For our church, that it may be like the rich soil that yields a harvest of 100-fold, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders in our great country who will govern in a way which is accountable to God and to all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For those who suffer, either mentally or physically, that they will seek our Lord's healing grace through the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For success to those who are working on a vaccine for COVID-19, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For all those who are not able to receive the precious body and blood of our Lord during this time, that they may feel his presence within them through prayer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick and who are dying, and for those whose names are written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Joan Molitor, Beatrice Trevino, Brian Fogel, Darwin Hamilton, Ken Chesney, Socorro Lomas, Gregoria Ramirez, and Mark Campbell. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the living and deceased members of St. Jude, for which this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Father in heaven, as we make this request in prayer, teach us to value your blessings. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that, when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as you celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
In receiving communion today, please note the following. You are strongly encouraged to receive communion in the hand. The priest, deacon, and Eucharistic ministers will all wear a face covering to distribute communion so that you can remove yours when it's time to receive. Please stay 6 feet apart as you come up for communion, which is about 2 pews. We will only have one line going up for communion to keep the 6-foot distance. We'll have one side of the pews goes first, the right side, followed by the left side, like we've been doing at daily mass. And please follow the usher's directions.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritui Sancto, sicura Amor, Deus in me.
those of you online, please join me in the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already in my heart and unite myself to you completely. Please do not let me ever be separated from you. So as you exit Mass today, please take your time and strive to maintain social distancing. And we ask you to please exit in order for us to start cleaning the church for the next Mass. And we want to thank those of you that have been able to support us the last few months during the closing of our Sunday Masses, and for those that continue to do so. Just a reminder, we have collection baskets back on the baptismal font and at the east and the west side of the transepts of the exits. Without Sunday Masses, the effects of COVID economically, our collections are down, as you might imagine. So we were having to make drastic cuts in our budget. Due to the current need for social distancing, our mission week for 2020 has been replaced with an inter-parish service event called Hands from Home. This is open to families of middle school and high school teens. And you can find more details and register online via our website. In the summer, we'll have two options for virtual VBS, Vacation Bible School. These programs are available until July the 24th. Please see the bulletin for details and registering online. Please be aware that we are continuing to have ministries available. Our Addiction Ministry and Career Alliance Ministry are both meeting virtually to offer assistance to anyone who needs it. We also have upcoming Bible studies and other ministries that will be meeting virtually as well. Finally, bulletins are available on our website and also by the exits for you to pick up as you leave the church. Thank you.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.